Breathing, the alphabet of the body. Breath is life. Breath is prana. William Reich has called it as orgone, the energy particles. The essential life force. Be aware of breathing and its techniques. Observe your incoming and outgoing breath. Observe your incoming and outgoing breath. Continue to observe your breathing. Each moment breath comes in and then goes out. Flow with the music as its rhythm is still something within you. The rhythm of the breathing is still within you. As you begin to observe your incoming and outgoing breath, breathing naturally slows down. You go on witnessing the breath. First it slows down and then it settles. And then the inner rhythm overflows as musical breath symphony. And with the settling of the breath, all vibrations cease as well. Not only has this also something settles deep within. Breath continues rhythmically both in and out. Flow with the rhythm of the music as it creates ripples within with each breath that comes in and then goes out. Still the vibration of the body continues. Also continues the one who witnesses this all, the subtle one. As witnessing continues, you enter into another realm. This is the realm of consciousness that witnesses all this. Through breathing, you can reach to the realm of the consciousness. Flow with existence. Something stills within, yet still there continues the vibrations of thoughts. This continues like the vibrations of the breath. The witness and the vibration of the breath continues. Flow with life as it unveils. The subtle witness of breath continues. There are many other vibrations that continue as well. These are vibrations of thoughts. Flow with being. Thoughts flow on the inner sky like the crowd on the busy place. This is like the crowd in a busy marketplace. People coming and going. So too, thoughts continue to float on the inner sky. Allow the life to flow within. Between these thoughts, there is a gap. The gap between two thoughts is precise. It is exactly like the gap between two breaths. The gap between two passers-by is the way to be aware of the gap between two thoughts and the gap between two breaths. Feel the stillness within. Beyond all vibrations is your Chaitanya or conscious form. No form is deeper than this. Like the ocean is the realm of this stillness. Out of this flow, silence flows. Out of this flow, silence in this total stillness. And you get the taste of your being. Allow the rhythm of the breathing to sink deep within. In this you experience your presence. In action, worldly experiences him. In action and in movement alone, a worldly experiences his presence, and the meditator experiences him in this stillness. Meditation is the process to experience you in this utter stillness. Still flows the inner music as breath slows breath is silent, thoughts have ceased. Breath is silent, thoughts have ceased, only being is there. Take a few deep breaths and be filled with gratitude. Such are the moments of inner drowning. Myriad gratitudes for this. Allow to drown still deeper within. To experience your being in a state of inactivity, inaction and thoughtlessness is understanding the breath, flowing with the breath, and this is meditation. A few deep breaths and again be filled with gratitude that you have such moments to drown in yourself. Such is new beginning, new life and new being. Breath is alpha in meditation, and with alpha omega is not far off. Breath is life. This is taste of your being. I have spoken the Kapalbhati, deep long breath and breath of fire. Vipassana, which is a breath observation, I will speak at another time. I will now take only a few breathing techniques. This is based on the works of a Canadian, Susan P. Bowles. When she first started taking Kundalini Yoga, she had a very hard time even getting on the floor. She had broken her back at work. Doing anything was extremely painful. Her teacher was very patient with her, allowing her to adopt positions she could not get into or found hard to maintain. After a few months and aid of other alternative healing methods, she was able to move with much greater mobility. Feeling the energy moves up her spine, the fire breath, actually just learning to breathe properly, helped her a lot. Now she says, if you look at her back, you will not find the break. She went from being wheelchair dependent according to allopathics to being able to anything she wanted. She does too. Most of us do not know how to breathe properly. We take shallow breath as if we are afraid of what breathing does. But breath is the alphabet of your body. So we should drink heavily and deeply to energize and feed our bodies through the breath. I was taught by breathing into count of four slow counts. Feel the breath, expand your ribcage. You are aiming to fill your whole chest cavity with air. At the end of the fourth, when you think you cannot take any more air in, take a sip more. Hold for a count of four. Exhale over a count of four again. And when you think you have all the air out, huff more out. You will be amazed how much you can get out after this count of four. You may experience burning in your lungs through this, but soon your breathing becomes deep and sure. And the count of four expands now to a count of five and six. I was told to concentrate on the emptiness between breathing in and breathing out, that period of stillness that exists between the two. Once my lungs were used to doing this, I started breathing from different parts of my body. No one taught me this. It just started to happen when I meditate. I would open up my crown chakra and breathe the energy down on an in-breath, feeling it blow around my heart, keeping it there. Then on the out-breath, put the breath down the rest of my body to exit out my feet. Then I would reverse it, breathing in my feet, feeling it flowing to my heart, then on the exhale, pushing it up out my head. It was dizzying at first, but energy that fills me when I do this is incredible. You will recall the light of the being meditation where you have been told to feel a great light descending around your head and then descending through the body and coming out through the toes, and then a great river flowing through the toes and going up. This is a similar air. Here you are not doing anything. The voice, the energy field does it all. In this breathing here, when you are breathing from the crown chakra, just a feeling and it begins to happen. Then you are letting the air out through the feet and reversing the process. I found out later that I was unconsciously doing something that is taught to get the energy flowing in the two currents that wind around our spines. The spine have two nerves, and in the center there is another one. One is known as the sun nerve, the other is known as moon nerve. You can allow the energy to flow downwards through one and upward through the other. You are not locating the actual nerves within your body, just focusing on your attention on that you are allowing this to happen through these nerves. A visualization. Automatically it begins to happen. We would practice this for about 5 minutes at the beginning of each session. It prepared us for the work in the session by calming us and getting our minds into the proper space for work. The fire breath is very different. Here you can concentrate on out breath as it is thrown out with such force. The in-breath comes after it automatically. We are taught to put our hands on our bellies and use those muscles to force the air out of the lungs in a whoosh. Our hands were to remind us to use those muscles to force it out. Your whole abdomen is used to empty the lungs very quickly. You should hear your breath coming out vocally, almost like a cough, but not so loud. It is kind of a huff sound. Here you are not using so much breath. It is like the sips in and whooshes out. It took me a while to get used to doing this. My stomach muscles hated me for a while, but it was worth everything to feel what I did when the rising started. At first we could not do it very much it was far too difficult to keep up. But as the weeks went by, we had longer lessons using this. In the beginning, always it happens when we have not learned the art of correct breathing. It is very difficult to breathe through the different parts of the body. You can breathe out through your eardrums, and in that it makes the eardrums flexible. You have taken the deep breath in, and then you hold the nostrils tightly and try to exhale with great force. The air comes out through the ears, and in that it vibrates the eardrums, which maintains its flexibility. In the process of time, the eardrums get harder. So it is easy to exhale through the different parts of the body. An effort, visualization is necessary. The alternate nostril breathing, which is anulom vilom, you inhale through one nostril using the thumb and the two first finger of the left hand if you are a right hander, and if you are a left hander, use the right, with the left thumb you put it on the left nostril and the two fingers on the right side of the nostril. You release the thumb, so you can breathe through the left nostril, then press the left nostril with the same thumb, and then you release the right nostril by raising the two fingers. The breath air comes out through the right nostril. Now the right nostril is open, you breathe through that. Then as soon as you have breathed in, close that nostril by pressing the two fingers on the right nostril. Release the thumb pressure on the left nostril. The air will come out of that. This is a reversible process. What it does, it actually massages your two sides of the brain. It establishes a balance between the two. Normally, in normal case, we tend to breathe through one side of the nostril alone. And if you notice, only one nostril remains open at a particular period of time. Then after some time, the other side opens and then the first side closes. This happens automatically. This is the reason that each meditation process supposed to go for 45 minutes, because this movement of the breathing through the different nostrils takes 45 minute cycle, 45 to 60 minute cycle. For 45 to 60 minutes, you breathe through left nostril, then the left nostril closes and you breathe through the right nostril. That is why in order for the meditation process to complete, you have to be in meditation for 45 to 60 minutes. Unless you are within the energy field of someone who can change this pattern. So when you are doing the reversible breathing process using the alternate nostrils, you are establishing a balance between the two sides of the brain, the left and the right sides. When they are balanced, then you can use either of the two sides consciously, and you come within the space between the two. Swami Chinmayanand has called these two sides of the brain as objective and subjective minds. And in between, there is a space which is the empty space, where there is no thoughts, no emotions, no feelings. The objective, as it is, it suggests object. It is more mathematical, logical side of your brain. This is the left side. The right side of the brain is subjective, subject oriented, which is your being, your consciousness, and there remains a gap between the two, separated. And when you are doing the alternate nostril breathing, you establish a connectivity between the two brains. So using the breath pranayama, you can enter into the state of meditation. But when we continue to do Hatha Yoga, the pranayams, we overlook why we are doing it. We forget the objective of it. We remain only in that. Everything that you are doing, every action is to establish inner serenity, harmony and oneness. Whether you are using breath as a tool or anything, but you remember breath is natural. You can use breath as a tool to bring calmness. When there is disturbance, there is anger, there is any other emotional disturbance, you can use the breath of fire to exhaust all that is negative in you, negative forces that is creating anger in you. Then breath can be used as a tool. The alternate nostril breathing was taught to us after the Evok 2. After doing the first breathing exercise a few times, raise one of your hands to your face. This is the technique which I had explained to you using the thumb and the two fingers to block the two nostrils and then continue to breathe. Continue to alternate with one complete inhalation and exhalation. You can do in the beginning to a certain cycles and then increase according to your capacity. Remember, breathing is the alphabet of the body. You can devote as much as 15 minutes to this. These breath-oriented pranayams, they have calming effects and they are also used as an important tool in the process of inner growth or inner sun of awakening, as Buddha calls it. His technique of vipassana, the breath watching, is the technique that was introduced by him to create the inner sun of awakening, to make you aware of it. These have calming and yet energizing effects on your various centers, creating a balance within the body and allow the upward surge of the energy. So energy that was going naturally downwards helps you to move upward. Even this meditation, the light of the being and relax into your being, are the two techniques of meditation that allows the upward movement of the energy. If you are consciously listening to those for a few moments to minutes, you will disappear as if you do not know what has happened. You know it very well that you did not fall asleep. That energy field that is contained in those two meditations creates an energy field that connects you to your being. This was all about the meditation techniques and various things. Vipassana is a topic by itself, which will be taken another time. So for now, only this much on the last part of the breathing techniques.